Hello learners, today in this video we are going to learn 7th standard science chapter number 2 plants structure and function. In the previous video we learned about stem and leaf. Before we get started, let's take a look at the agenda. The first module is flower, where we will see different parts of it in details, followed by next module fruit, in which we will focus on characteristics of fruits and its functions. Let's begin with parts of a flower: pedicel, receptacle, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium are different parts of flower. Let's get familiar with each part of a flower in detail. The stalk of the flower is called pedicel. It may be long or short. One end of it is attached to the stem. End of the pedicel, which is attached to flower, is expanded or enlarged and swollen. This is called receptacle. Petals and other parts of flower are supported on the receptacle. The bud condition: the petals are covered by leaf-like parts called sepals, which are green in color. They form calyx. Petals make the corolla. Petals may be color or white. This is the second hole of a flower. It contains petals, which serve two main functions. The first function is to attract pollinators. Pollinators means animals or insects that transfer pollen from plant to plant. And the second one is to protect the reproductive parts of a flower. Petals are brightly colored and scented to attract animals and insects for pollination. Androecium. Androecium is the male reproductive part of the flower. It consists of stamen. Each stamen is made up of anther and filament. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the flower. It is made up of carpels. A carpel consists of stigma, style and ovary. This is all about the parts of a flower. Let's move towards the next module, that is pollination. Pollination is the act of transferring pollen grains from the male anther to the flower of the female stigma. The goal of every living organism, including plants, is to create offspring for the next generation. One of the ways that plants can produce offspring is by making seeds. Seeds contain the genetic information to produce a new plant. How does pollen get from one flower to another flower? Flowers must rely on vectors to move pollen. These vectors can include wind, water, birds, insects, butterflies, bats, and other animals that visit flowers. We call animals or insects that transfer pollen from one plant to another plant is pollinators. Next is fertilization. Fertilization is the process in which ovules means egg cell in the ovary get fertilized by the pollen grains fallen on stigma. Seeds are formed from fertilized ovules and the ovary develop into fruit. Now let's get acquainted with functions of flower. They are, the flowers can produce diaspores. Diaspores means seed or other structure that functions in plant dispersal without fertilization. The next function is, after fertilization, the ovary of the flower develops into a fruit containing a seed. Next one is, the most important function of flower is a reproduction. The last one is, flowers provide nectar to certain birds and insects, which in turn help in the transfer of pollen from one flower to the other. Our next module is fruit. A fruit is the part of plant that develops from flowers. Each fruit has its own specific characteristics. The variation in fruits are with respect to their shapes, color, taste, skin or shell, fleshy parts and seeds, etc. Fruits like cashew has its seed outside the fruit. Dicotyledonous seeds can be divided into two equal parts. Monocotyledonous cannot be divided into two equal parts. Now let's see functions of fruits. First function is protection of seeds. And the second one is storage of food materials. Now let's summarize what we have learned in this session. Students got familiar with different parts of flowers and their functions. Then they got familiar with the process like pollination and fertilization. Lastly, we got acquainted with fruit and functions of fruit.